Hello friends, myself Devendra Singh Negi, Managing Director Engineers of Faculty Thermal and Fluid Sciences. So, as you know my friends, on 1st of Feb, GATE 2020 was over. And if you compare the GATE 2020 with GATE 2019, the paper was a little difficult as compared to last year paper. And if you compare the forenoon session and afternoon session of GATE 2020, it was observed that afternoon session was a little difficult as compared to forenoon session. So today I'm going to discuss the questions, all questions of thermal and fluid sciences which came in GATE 2020. Please stay tuned. So this is one of the question which came from thermodynamics. 1 kg of air initially at temperature of 127 degrees Celsius expands reversibly at a constant pressure until the volume doubles. If the gas constant of air is 287 joule per kg per Kelvin, the magnitude of work interaction is dash kilojoule. So if you see the question, mass of air is given, mass of air is given 1 kg, initial temperature is given 127 degrees Celsius. So if we try to convert into Kelvin, 127 plus 273, 400 Kelvin. Now isobaric process is given, constant pressure process is given, pressure is constant until the volume doubles. That means final volume is 2 times of initial volume. So V2 is 2 times of V1. If the gas constant of the air is 287 joule per kg per Kelvin, so R is given, R is 287 joule per kg per Kelvin. The magnitude of work interaction is, so he is asking displacement work 1 to 2. Now, if you try to represent this process 1 to 2 on PV diagram, it will look like this. Please observe. Let me assume this vertical axis is representing pressure. Let me say this horizontal axis is representing volume axis. So, the initial volume is V1. Initial volume is V1. And the volume is increasing at constant pressure from V1 to V2 in such a way that V2 is 2 times of V1. Now for such cases we have seen in class that the displacement work will be P into delta V, where delta V is change in volume. So look at here my friends, displacement work 1 to 2 will be P delta V, V2 minus V1. Now this V2 is already 2 times of V1. So WD 1 to 2 is P 2V1 minus V1. So basically what I'm getting is displacement work 1 to 2 will be P V1. Now if I'm assuming air is behaving as an ideal gas, PV is equal to MRT, this can be written as MRT1. So let us substitute the values, whatever we are having my friends. Mass is 1 kg, R is 287, temperature is 400 Kelvin. So if you multiply, displacement work will be 11. This much joule. He is asking the answer in kilojoule. So WD 1 to 2 will be 114.8 kilojoule. This is the answer, my friends. Let us go to the next question. So, my friend, this is another question which came in forenoon session from thermodynamics. For an ideal gas, a constant pressure and a constant volume line intersect at a point in the temperature versus specific entropy diagram. The ratio of the slopes of the constant pressure line to the constant volume line at the point of intersection is. So it is a straightforward question from the notes. If you see, we know dt by ds for constant pressure line is basically T by Cp. Now, if you observe, dt by ds of constant volume line is T by Cv. That means the slope of isobaric curve on TS diagram is T by Cp. Slope of isochoric curve on TS diagram is T by Cv. Now, what he is asking in question is, look at here, my friends. Let me say, this vertical axis is representing temperature axis. This horizontal axis is representing specific entropy. So as you can see, Cp is greater than Cv. The meaning is, on TS diagram, isochoric curve will be having the more slope as compared to isobaric curve. Okay, so let me say this line is representing isobar, then isochoric process will be having the more slope. Fine. So he's asking, what is the ratio of the slopes of the constant pressure to the constant volume line at the point of intersection? So let us suppose this is equation number A. Let us suppose this is equation number A. Let us suppose this is equation number B. So he is asking the ratio of this to this. So let us do one thing, my friends. Equation A divided by equation B. So let us see, what are we getting? Dt by ds constant pressure divided by dt by ds at constant volume is equal to T by Cp T by Cv. This tt will be getting cancelled, and finally we'll be ending up with dt by ds of the constant pressure curve divided by dt by ds of isochoric curve is equal to Cv by Cp. If you want, you can say 1 by gamma also. We'll go to next question. So this is the third question from thermodynamics in Forenoon session. For an ideal gas, the magnitude of Joule Thomson coefficient is, of course we know, my friends, as we have discussed in class also, for an ideal gas, the magnitude of Joule Thomson coefficient is 0. If you want, we can derive also. Look, Joule Thomson coefficient mu can be written as T dou V by dou T at constant pressure minus specific volume divided by Cp. Now look at here, my friends, for ideal gas, we have ideal gas equation which says P small V is equal to RT. Now from this equation, if I try to find dou V by dou T at constant pressure, so dou V by dou T at constant pressure will be equal to R by P. So let us substitute in this mu formula. So let us see, for an ideal gas, what are we getting? Mu is equal to T R by P minus small V divided by Cp. My friends, this R into T will be PV. P and P will be getting cancelled. V minus V will be 0. So Joule Thomson coefficient for an ideal gas is 0. Now what is the physical meaning of this? What are we getting from this information? The information is, during throttling process of an ideal gas, as the pressure decreases, the temperature will not change. And my friends, if you see, that is the reason why in air refrigerant cycles, where air is the working fluid, we don't use throttling device to decrease the pressure along with temperature, because temperature will not change for ideal gas. So what happens there, we are using the expanders, and with the help of expanders we are decreasing the temperature along with pressure. Thank you. So my friends, this is one of the questions which came from applications of thermodynamics part. This question is based on Otto cycle. Let us read the question. The indicated power developed by an engine with compression ratio 8 is calculated using an air standard Otto cycle. The rate of heat addition is 10 kilowatt. The ratio of the specific heats at constant pressure and constant volume is gamma. The mechanical efficiency of the engine is 80%. The brake power output of the engine in kilowatt is, so let us write the data whatever is given to us, my friends. So compression ratio is given, R is given, basically R is given as 8, and of course Otto cycle is given. The engine is based on Otto cycle, fine. The heat supply rate is given, Q dot S is given as 10 kilowatt, okay. The ratio of the specific heats at constant pressure and constant volume is 1.4. Gamma is given as 1.4. Fine. The mechanical efficiency of the engine is 80%. Let me represent mechanical efficiency by eta M. It is given as 80%, or you can write as 0.8. The brake power output of the engine in kilowatt is, so he is asking brake power. So let us see from where we can calculate this brake power. So my friends, indicated power and brake power is related by mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is basically brake power divided by indicated power. So brake power is equal to eta M indicated power. Now the question is from where to get this indicated power. So my friends, thermal efficiency of Otto cycle can be written as indicated power divided by heat supplied rate. Now what is thermal efficiency of the Otto cycle? It is 1 minus 1 upon R power gamma minus 1. So from here we can calculate the indicated power. So indicated power will be coming as 1 minus 1 upon R power gamma minus 1 into Q dot S. Let us substitute this indicated power in this brake power formula. So let us see what are we getting, my friends. Brake power is equal to eta M 1 minus 1 upon R power gamma minus 1 Q dot S. So let us substitute the values, my friends. Brake power is equal to what? 0.8, 1 minus 1 upon 8 power gamma minus 1 is 0.4 into Q dot S. Q dot S is 10 kilowatt. So if you observe, 10 into 0.8 will be 8. And it will be around 0.5 something. So answer will be 4.5178 kilowatt. Thank you. So my friend, this is another question from applications of thermodynamics part. Let us read the question. Air, in bracket ideal gas, enters perfectly insulated compressor at a temperature of 310 Kelvin. The pressure ratio of the compressor is 6. A specific heat at constant pressure for air is 1005 joule per kg per Kelvin, and ratio of specific heats at constant pressure and constant volume is 1.4. If the isentropic efficiency of the compressor is 85%, the difference of enthalpies of air between the exit and the inlet of the compressor is in joule, in kilojoule per kg he is asking. So let us write the data which is given in the question. Inlet temperature is given, my friend. So let me represent inlet by 1. So T1 is given and it is 310 Kelvin. Fine. Pressure ratio is given, RP, let me represent the pressure ratio as RP. RP is given as 6. CP is given 1005 joule per kg per Kelvin, and gamma is given as 1.4. And the isentropic efficiency of the compressor is given, let me represent by eta IC, it is 85%, the meaning is 0.85. He is asking the difference of the difference in enthalpies of air between the exit and inlet of the compressor. So first let us try to understand what is the meaning of isentropic efficiency. So look at here, my friends. Let us suppose this vertical axis is representing a specific enthalpy. This horizontal axis is representing a specific entropy. And let me say I am drawing two isobars. Let me say it is lower pressure, PL is equal to constant. Here on this isobar, pressure is PH, PH is equal to constant. So look at here, my friends. Let us suppose I am having isentropic compression from pressure PL to PH. So during isentropic compression, the entropy change of the working fluid will be zero, so I will be getting the vertical line. So in that case, my friends, this H2 minus H1 will be representing the isentropic work input. Now let us see what will be the case for actual work input, actual compression, where I am having some irreversibilities. So my friends, let us suppose I am doing the internally irreversible compression from 1 to 2', that is from pressure PL to PH. Then you will be able to understand, my friends, H2', this H2' minus H1 will be representing the actual work input to the compressor. So you can observe that actual work input is more than the isentropic work input to the compressor. So basically, isentropic efficiency of the compressor will be isentropic work input divided by actual work input to the compressor. So we can write, my friends, actual work input to the compressor is equal to isentropic work input to the compressor divided by isentropic efficiency of the compressor. So let us substitute. This is basically H2' minus H1. Wi is basically H2 minus H1 divided by eta IC. Now, since air is behaving as an ideal gas, for an ideal gas, delta H, that is H2 minus H1, can be written as Cp delta T, that is Cp T2 minus T1. So let us see, my friends, what are we getting? H2' minus H1 is equal to Cp T2 minus T1 divided by eta IC. Now, my friends, we know for isentropic compression, T2 and T1 can be related with the help of pressure ratio. T2 is equal to T1 Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So let us see what are we getting. H2' minus H1 is equal to Cp in bracket T1 Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus T1 divided by eta ic. My friend, T1 we can take common. So S2 dash minus H1 is equal to Cp T1 Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1 divided by eta ic. So let us try to substitute the values, my friends. S2 dash minus H1 is equal to Cp. Let me write in kilojoule per kg, 1.005. T1 is 310 into Rp power. That means 6 power 0.4 divided by 1.4 minus 1 divided by eta ic, which is 0.85. My friends, if I'm solving this, I will be getting S2 dash minus H1 is equal to 245.028 kilojoule per kg. This is the answer, my friends. Now, from here, let us try to understand what are the things required for solving this problem. First of all, you should know that what is the meaning of isentropic efficiency. Once you know the meaning of isentropic efficiency, then the second thing which is required for solving this problem is this relation T2 is equal to T1 Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Okay, so the answer is 245.028 kilojoule per kg. Let us go to next question. So this is one of the questions which is based on Breton cycle with intercooling. Let us read the question. The compressor of a gas turbine power plant operating on an ideal intercooled Breton cycle accomplishes an overall compression ratio of 6 in 2-stage compression process. Okay. The air enters the compressor at 300 Kelvin and 100 kilopascal. Fine. If the properties of the gas are constant, the intercooling pressure for minimum compressor work is dash kilopascal. So if you try to understand what is happening, my friends, the compression is taking place in two phase and in between I am doing the intercooling. So let us try to represent this particular process on PV diagram. So if you observe, my friend, let me say this vertical line is representing pressure axis. Let me say this horizontal axis is representing a specific volume. Let me say this horizontal line is representing lower pressure before compression. Let me say this particular horizontal line is representing intercooler pressure. Let me say this horizontal line is representing the final pressure after compression. So what happens, please try to understand. First, the compression takes place from PL to PI. Now, at this constant pressure PI, the intercooling takes place. Now, again, the compression will take place from this pressure PI to PH. So, generally, you can observe the area projected under the curve on pressure axis is decreasing, and that is the main reason why intercooling is used. It decreases the area under the curve projected on pressure axis. That means it is decreasing the work input given to the compressor. Let us come back to the question. He has given overall compression ratio is 6. The meaning is pH by PL is 6, or you can say pH is equal to 6 PL. Fine. PL is given. Air enters the compressor at 300 Kelvin and 100 kilopascal. That means PL is given. PL is 100 kilopascal. Now, my friends, if you do little bit of calculations for perfect intercooling and for minimum work input given to the compressor, we can observe that intercooler pressure will be the geometric mean of pH PL. Now, if I substitute the values, pH is 6 times of PL, so I'm getting 6 PL into PL, PL square. So PI will be basically equal to root 6 PL. So PI is equal to, if you see the value of root 6, 2.449, whereas PL is given as 100, so the PI will be 244.9 kilopascal. So this is the pressure of the intercooler, which will be giving you the minimum compressor work input for perfect intercooling. Thank you. So this is another question which is based on ideal Rankine cycle. So let us read the problem. For an ideal Rankine cycle operating between pressures of 30 bar and 0.04 bar, the work output of the turbine is 903 kilojoule per kg, and the work input to the feed pump is 3 kilojoule per kg. The specific steam consumption is dash kg per kilowatt hour. So let us see what is the data given. Boiler pressure is given to us, my friends. Boiler pressure is given as 30 bar, and condenser pressure is given as 0.04 bar. Okay, a specific work output of the turbine is given, which is 903 kilojoule per kg. A specific work input to the pump is given as 3 kilojoule per kg, and he is asking what is the value of specific steam consumption. So my friend, very simple question. We already know specific steam consumption is 3600 divided by net work output. So look at here, my friends, specific steam consumption is equal to 3600 divided by net work output. So basically specific steam consumption will be equal to 3600 divided by net work output will be work output of the turbine minus work input to the pump. So specific steam consumption will be 3600 divided by 903 minus 3. So if you solve, you will be getting 3600 divided by 900. So finally, it will be coming out to be 4 kg per kilowatt hour. The meaning is, for producing 1 kilowatt hour of the net work output, we need 4 kg of steam. So what is the physical meaning of this value of specific steam consumption? Basically defines the size of the power plant. Higher the value of specific steam consumption, higher will be the mass flow rate, bigger will be the power plant. Okay, thank you.